Hello everyone, this is my game Xenoscape. Xenoscape is a bullet hell game about evolving, swapping, and leveling up creatures in an immersive and action-filled world. There are currently three playable characters in the game, and I plan to add more into the future. These characters are the Fire, Water, and Earth Sprite. Each of these characters has unique bullets, abilities, and interactions. The first character we're going to look at is the Fire Sprite. Fire Sprite has two abilities, one of them being the ability to move in and control fire, and the second is a fireball ability. The Fire Sprite's bullets will run out after a short amount of time. This is based on the amount of dexterity that the character has. Think of this as a magazine on a gun. Once he shoots a certain amount, the magazine's number of bullets goes down. Once these bullets disappear, the magazine is refilled. The next character, and my favorite, is the Water Sprite. The Water Sprite has two abilities. The first of these two abilities is its shift, which gives it the power to dash forward quickly, and any bullets that it collides with while dashing will deal negative damage and in effect healing it. This is only active when you see the small blue hexagon around it. This kind of gives the player a risk versus reward system where they are able to dash in to heal, especially at low health, but it's risky because it requires you to collide with bullets and it's only active for a short amount of time. This is one of my favorite abilities just because it's very almost kind of hard to use, but in a fun way, which is kind of a weird way to describe that, but it's a very, very fun ability to use. This is especially useful to get out of a lot of tough situations, such as being trapped in corners, dealing with enemies that have a lot of projectiles towards you, and just in general, getting around the map and for mobility. The dash is based on the direction that you're currently traveling. It makes this kind of snappy back and forth motion. If you were to run, say you're running forward and you quickly snap back and press shift, then you will completely switch directions and it feels very very nice, very quick and responsive. This is especially useful for when you're using its second ability, which is the bubble shotgun, allowing you to get up real close to enemies and then dash out of danger while also healing. Here are quick examples of all of the three space abilities. This is the Fire Sprite's face. This is very useful for three things: healing yourself, damage, and providing yourself with armor. This is the Earth Sprite's space, Gravity Well. This is effective on everything that's a physics object. It can be used to slow down enemies, speed up your bullets, or clump enemies into a small area to deal a lot of damage. The last space ability is the Water Sprite. This is the Bubble Cannon. It deals huge amounts of damage. The Bubble Cannon is best used in combination with the Shift ability, having you dash in, release your Bubble Cannon, and then quickly dash out. On collision with enemies and destructible objects, the Fire Sprite's bullets spawn fire, and you can use this to suck back in and heal yourself. The Earth Sprite's shift is a rock. Doesn't sound very cool, but you see it in action. It has a short distance that it travels, and it moves towards your cursor in this distance, so you can actually curve it around corners and flip the rock in different directions. This also affects everything that's a physics object, so shooting it into an enemy has the ability to knock them back pretty far, keep them out of your way, like that. This dungeon is one I created for the Scream Jam 2020. The purpose of this dungeon is to provide kind of an interactive experience of what I think the SCP Foundation would be like. There's a couple Easter eggs hidden in it, and each of the enemies has their own unique ways of attacking. SCP-49, the Plague Doctor, can turn D-class, which are the little orange prisoner guys, into zombies. Each of them does their own thing, and they're all based on the stories of the SCPs that they are from. So SCP-49 is this plague doctor guy, and he has the ability to turn other people into instances of, I guess, like almost zombie-like creatures. The D-class turn into zombies and will attack you, and when their bullets hit SCP-49, they actually heal it up. So he's a pretty cool one. I think he's actually my favorite of all of the four that I made. The two in there are the peanut guy and the shy guy, and they both have vision-based mechanics in them. So if you're facing them or whatever, they will attack. There's a lot that I've put into this dungeon. I'm very proud of my work. I think it turned out very cool. Also, like the way that the fire sprite turned out, and you know, the game is it's coming along. It's very fun to play at this point, which is, you know, something that I'm proud of. It's very, very immersive, and you know, I see myself playing this game all the time. But anyway, here's some B-roll. Enjoy.
What can I say? I am so grateful for your stupidity. It's sad, do you not understand that which I am? Dear Ouroboros, I am its teeth. Dear Ouroboros, you are its tail. Dear Ouroboros must eat itself.